Osaka, Japan, the stage for the next installment in a great skating rivalry, Eldridge versus Stoico.
I've competed against Elvis for a long time.
Through the years, we've duked it out.
We've had a lot of good battles.
And here again, we're gonna do it again.
In this short program, Elvis opened up on a planned quad jump and landed in a disappointing fourth place. Meanwhile, Todd was the aggressor. Crisp and clean, he took the lead, and more importantly, showed the world and the international judges that he is definitely back. The showdown between two former world champions set to go inside the pool and ice arena here in Osaka, Japan. The men's free skate about to get underway at the Four Continents Figure Skating Championships. Hi again, everybody. Terry Gannon along with Dick Button. Of the top seven men in the standings so far, five of them did quadruple jumps in this short program. But interestingly enough, Dick, the two headliners, Todd Eldridge and Elvis Stoico, were the two who did not. What are your thoughts on Eldridge coming back to eligible skating?
Well, you know, this sport never ceases to amaze me. I mean, it casts a spell on you that you simply cannot escape. Look at Todd Eldridge. He's 28. He's made three runs for Olympic medals, but he's never gotten one. He's won world and national titles and a lot of other gold. But now he's casting his net at a fourth Olympic run, starting right here. So what are his chances? Well, we've heard a lot about the necessity of having quads. Six skaters have them here, but he doesn't. But he's in the lead. His jumps are great, his spins the best. Are we getting mixed messages about what it's going to take to win Olympic gold? Well, stay tuned. You'll get one answer at least in this championship.
So far, so good in terms of that return. The five-time U.S. champion in the lead right now, heading to the free skate against two very talented skaters from China. And Elvis Stoico in fourth. He's got a lot of work to do, but he can win today here in Japan. On the ice first, the 23-year-old from Chichihar, China, Min Zhang, in third place after the short program, trying to steal the thunder here from the two world champions. Bit of a surprise so far.
I think he's also trying to steal the thunder in his own country to get onto that world team, one of the goals of this event. Eight. He is not one of the short skaters. Good long body as he does that triple axel, triple toe loop.
Two quads planned in this free skate.
The quad toe loop coming up right here. Turn step. Beautifully done. Oh, that was a quad toe, triple toe. And that was as easy and as complete as I've ever seen them done.
He told us this week he did his first quad in competition all the way back in 1993, and that there are seven or eight other Chinese skaters who can do at least two different quads in one program.
I think what it means is that quads will be simply part of the repertoire as we get to the 2002 Olympics. They'll neither be important, but will you be able to win without them? I'm quite sure that that will be the case. That'll be the case because so many other skaters will have so much of the rest of the package to go with the quads.
You mentioned earlier, Dick, Min Zhang trying to make the world championship team from China. Zheng Jin Guo will be there, number one Chinese skater. And the other spot they have two is up for grabs. We may see Cheng Zheng Li, who is still to skate, or Zhang in Nice.
the loop.
Ah, beautiful, beautiful quadruple toe. Jump. Now you notice the cleanness of the revolution in the air. It's very tight, very fast, and easily breaks out before he starts to descend from the peak of the jump. But with that type of spinning ability in the air, I'm surprised that he isn't a better spinner on the ice. This is very mediocre sit spin. The back is bent, there's no speed, and it's very sort of just thrown away. After all these magnificent jumps now, he's ending his program with this combination spin. Notice the dipping there, he didn't catch it. The hook at the beginning, the sit spin, very, very weak position. And a back crossfoot that is novice at the very best. You know, he's a brilliant jumper, just brilliant. I mean, the quality of that jumping is first rate. And the music was nice. He has good flow and good speed and needs a great deal of attention for those other elements, such as his spins, to be able to come out at the top of this world.
The bronze medalist from the Chinese National Championships, Min Zhang. Two sets of marks, as always, for this free skate. The first for technical merit, the second for presentation. 5.6 to 5.8 the range in the first set.
And they're wonderful marks, and he deserves it for the quality of the jumping. It would have been higher, I think, had he gotten the whole package in there.
And the low end is lower for presentation, 5.3 up to a 5.8. Though, and remember, Min Zhang of China was in third place after the short program. The five-time U.S. champion hit the peak of his career in 1996 with a gold medal at the World Championships. But just 2 years later, his Olympic dreams were shattered. A disappointing free skate and a fourth-place finish. He's here in Japan to begin a comeback for that elusive medal in the 2002 Salt Lake Olympics.
The Olympic Games, hopefully getting there again and you know, maybe having the opportunity to skate the way that I want to and take home a medal from there would be fantastic. I mean, I'm really looking forward to trying to get there, for a third time and especially having the games in the U.S. I think it'll be pretty cool.
He's in first place after the short program. Todd Eldridge takes the ice when we come back.
Signature service every 3,000 miles. And some cars don't. Jiffy Lube Signature Service is complete car care using Pennzoil and Quaker State products. Does your car get it?
Some people don't care about the cold or worry about the weather. It seems they're always ready to face whatever nature throws their way. With Ricola, makers of naturally effective herbal cough drops for over 60 years. Ricola, a mountain of herbal expertise.
For Paul Kariya and the Mighty Ducks, the playoffs start right now because they're on the outside looking in. Jeremy Roenick and the Coyotes would love to play the spoiler. Coyotes, Mighty Ducks, Sunday at 8, only on ESPN. This is the game.
The men's championship continues, and here is the 96 world champion. He's back. Todd Eldridge, the five-time U.S. champ, re-injured a left ankle that has bothered him since last summer. here in Japan while practicing, took a day off. It didn't seem to bother him during the short program. He is the leader.
Now, he has a quadruple jump planned. The question is whether he'll go through with the attempt to do it. The music, The 13th Warrior from the motion picture. Yes, no, yes. And he fell. So that answers that question. Yes, no, yes.
That's exactly what he was thinking, I believe. Did not have a chance to land that quad. It would have been the first time he's ever landed it in competition.
This is his triple axle, triple toe. Now look at how he curves around here and steps up into that. And he landed that with such insecurity and such incompleteness that it did not become a combination and there was no triple toe. No markdowns, but the triple axel won't be considered as well done as it could have been. Double Lutz jump. Boy, this is not his day. Notice he tilts his head a lot. Sort of an idiosyncratic move.
Of Eldridge and Elvis, they have gone head-to-head in the World Championships six times, with each finishing higher than the other three times. Of course, Elvis has won three world titles.
Up into this double axle. Originally thought it might be a triple axle. So death drop into a back sit spin. His back spins are first rate. And a butterfly into a final spin. Now watch, first the camel, then the sit spin. Good speed, good centering, good back position. The back could be a little straighter, except on the pancake part, and a fine, fine back spin. Well, that was a program which was just off the mark almost all the way through it. jumps missed, jumps ignored, mistakes made, and the spark wasn't there. I don't think he can be very happy about this performance.
He's not. You can tell by his reaction. We've learned that it's not all about the quad, but the rest of the package wasn't there today from Todd Eldridge.
Now, look at this quadruple as he turns and then steps and stretches into it. The stretch was hardly back at all, and you can see the body leaning out of the circle halfway through it. Now, look here again as he steps into this. First the step, now the toe pick, almost like a salchow, but it's not. And there in the air, you can see him leaning to the outside, and he cannot sustain the landing.
5-0, 5-4. 5-3,
it'll be interesting to see
5-3,
now from the judges.
5-2,
Min Zhang, remember,
5-3,
did two quads
4-9,
in his
5-2,
program.
5-3,
technical merit marks
4.9.
Oh, these are, I mean, these are the lowest marks I think Todd Eldridge has received on technical merit 5-1, in a long time.
5-7,
and now for presentation, Dick, those 5-7, are higher, 5.1 to 5.8, 5-6, but not high enough.
Nope, there's a lot of 5.6s in there and 5.5s, which is not good.
Thank so you. Todd now in second place behind Min Zhang of China.
Representing China, Chen Zhang Li.
On the ice now, Chengzhen Li of China in second place. Obviously a chance to win here in Japan, and one of those trying to make the two spots on the Chinese World Championship team.
And he, like Todd Eldridge, both did dazzling short programs here. See if it can sustain it through this. The music, the Oasis. This is his quadruple toe loop right here. Ooh, wow, he saved that and went into a double toe loop. That's called saving a jump.
Silver medalist from the Chinese National Championships, 20 years of age, from Chengcheng, China.
And here's his triple axel, triple toe. Watch him as he steps forward into this. Ooh, such good turns in the air. Those legs just... they just were so tight. That's marvelous to see.
Remarkable to see the emergence of the Chinese skaters, too. There are so many now who have so much talent. Chengzhen Li was inspired by Liu Chen when he was a youngster.
Position. The arms are sort of casual, a little sloppy placed on the knee like that. But overall, a very good sit spin. serpentine footwork, but the speed of it is very slow. Rather unusual to do something that slowly at the end of the program when you want the judges to remember your speed. Was interesting. He really had some dazzling jumps, and the first three quarters of the program was far more entertaining than the last section of it was. It just sort of slowed down at the end.
Well, the judges will have a difficult decision. So will the Chinese Federation, sending that second skater to the World Championships. His teammate Min Zhang has the lead right now, but Cheng Zheng Li, awfully good.
5-7, 5-6.
When he was a youngster, he went to a nearby rink. Liu Chen, the 95 world champion, was skating there. From that point on, he was hooked. Now the marks, 5.5 up to 5.8.
Very steady marks, very good ones. I think the only problem he had was that he got overly cautious at the end.
Second set now, Dick, 5.4 up to 5.7. And those are good enough to put Cheng Zheng Li into the lead over his teammate, Min Zhang. Todd Eldred falls to third place.
Two rather incredible young Chinese skaters.
He won his sixth national title just weeks ago, and it was an emotional victory after years of battling injuries.
There's so many stages to what I've gone through, but this is a big stage in my life. It's coming back after a very difficult time, a very difficult period. I could have easily given up and just turned pro and went for the whole money thing and just do the whole pro circuit. But I decided to keep continuing. So when it all came together at Nationals again, it felt good. Finished the last jump, triple sal at the end, and then go into the fast scratch spin. The place just exploded. It just totally exploded, and it felt really good.
Elvis goes for a repeat performance and the gold medal when we return.
On the ice, representing Canada, Elvis Stoko.
And here's the man who'll be going for his fourth world championship in Nice, Elvis Stoko. The 27-year-old from Ontario, Canada, who now trains in Aston, Pennsylvania, Philadelphia area, in fourth place after the short program, but he can win if he wins this free skate.
You know, he's competed against Todd Eldridge six times in the world, and they've each won higher than the other three times even.
Cheng Zheng Li, Min Zhang, Todd Eldridge, your top three right now.
Music from the motion picture, The Mummy. And he opens with his quadruple toe jump. Nope, landed with the back foot forward on the landing. Double-footed it coming, double-turned it coming out. One of the reasons his jumps are successful, he believes very strongly in getting up first before he starts the revolution. See what happens right here? Beautiful triple axel.
Coming off perhaps his best performance in 2 years at the Canadian National Championships, which he won. He had quads in both the short and the free skate. And three perfect 6.0s for technical merit in that free skate.
Number
also Triple Toe Loop. That was the combination that didn't happen before. Flip. Footwork, picking up the speed and the tension in the program at this point. Forward scratch spin. Good spin. Good spin. Those scratch spins take more out of you than six of the jumps. That's why they're usually done right at the end of the program when you don't need energy to get off the ice.
Wants to pursue an acting career when he's done with skating. Let's hope those movies are better than the original Elvis ones. Elvis Stoiko, not going anywhere for a while, though. He's on the eligible scene and skating well.
There's nothing like the way I feel after a good night's sleep. That's why I love my Tylenol PM. For me, there's just no reason to have trouble sleeping. I take Tylenol PM before bed. It stops my pain and helps me sleep. So I'm ready for another great day.
Hi.
Hi, I noticed you didn't dial 1010321. Don't you want to save money?
Well, sure, but to get a low rate, you have to pay a monthly fee.
Not with 1010321. You get 50% off calls over 10 minutes. That's 8 cents a minute, day or night, without a monthly fee.
8 cents, no fee? I really can save a lot with 1010321.
Exactly. Dial 1010321.
There's nothing like the way I feel after a good night's sleep. That's why I love my Tylenol PM. For me, there's just no reason to have trouble sleeping. I take Tylenol PM before bed. It stops my pain and helps me sleep. So I'm ready for another great day.
The first race of the season will reveal who's back on track and who needs some fine-tuning. The 2000 CART FedEx Champion Series opens on the oval by the beach. Toyota presents the Grand Prix of Miami, Sunday at 4:30 on ESPN.
ESPN's coverage of the Four Continents Figure Skating Championships is brought to you by Chevrolet. Chevy, we'll be there. Now, because Todd Eldridge, the leader after the short program, was beaten here in the free skate, Elvis, who is in fourth heading to the free skate, can win. The first set of marks for technical merit. There they are, Dick.
Well, they're very strong technical marks. He did everything very well, and that was kind of, he didn't quite have the quadruple combination, quadruple jumps that the others did, but the rest of the program was very complete in the sense that the spins were good, and he took his time and energy in the program.
And here are the presentation marks. Yeah, he just realized it. Elvis Stoiko finishes on top.
And the presentation marks are very strong. 5-7, 5-8, 5-9.
Elvis, the winner of the Four Continents Figure Skating Championships. His mother was just in there with a congratulatory kiss. Uschi Kessler, his coach. The hug. Elvis ahead of Cheng Jing Li and Min Zhang, and Todd Eldridge finishes fourth.
That was a tight show right there.
So Elvis will pick up a check for $22,000 with the win here in Japan. Li
finishes second over Zhang. That could be an important silver medal for him. Chinese Federation making a decision on who to send to the World Championships. And Todd Eldridge, a disappointing free skate after a great short program. One of the judges actually placed him in eighth place in the free skate. He finishes fourth. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com, part of the Go Network. Go.com.